Y'all, I got my very first PR package. Meat is done, noodles is done, the cheese is almost done. I added the Rotel and I took the chicken off because I'm about to make the Alfredo sauce. Look at it, that's what I'm talking about right there. Y'all, I got my very first PR package. Good Molecules reached out to me. And I'm so excited. That sounds so cool to say. They reached out to me. And sent me this. It's perfect. It's skincare. Y'all, I need something for my skin. Obviously, if y'all can see on my videos, I have some black spots. So they ask you, what are your concerns with your skin? And they send you products based on that. So we are going to try this out, y'all. I'm so excited.
The box was upside down, y'all, but look.
Okay, we're about to open it. I'm about to open it. I'm about to let y'all see what's inside. All right, y'all. So it comes with these products. Well, some of them, because remember I told y'all, they basically ask you what are the problems with your skin and they send products based on that. So of course it has the steps here and then it has the products here based on step. So I got these four products, okay? And it came with this card and a message about the brand, etc. And then let's see what my steps are. So I think I saw from my steps, I have steps 2, 3, 3, and 4. Because my concern is really discoloration and things like that. So step 2 is the niacinamide brightening toner. So that's on here. And then step 3, and the other step 3 is overnight exfoliating treatment and discoloration correcting serum. And then step 4, lightweight daily moisturizer. So of course I would like to get the step 1, which is cleanse. But they did not send me that, which is fine, you know, because this is a PR package. But I am excited to try this, y'all. I'm excited to see if I will see any difference. But I'm really eager to get some new skincare because I don't really take care of my skin like I should. So when they reached out to me, I was just like, oh yeah, let's try it out and see. But yeah, the packaging is really pretty. But yeah, this is it. I'm excited. If you've ever tried Good Molecules, let me know. But yeah, I'm excited. Okay, I'm not gonna show y'all the cooking process because it's a lot, but I got all my fresh veggies. I do not waste my time cutting these up. Kroger and H-E-B sell them for a reason, okay? So that's your mixed peppers, that's cilantro and onions. This is cilantro, this is parsley. This is my ground beef, well, ground turkey. We don't eat beef in this house, the ground turkey in this house. I mean, we don't eat ground beef in this house. So that's my ground turkey for the nachos. This is cheese back there. That's the noodles for the chicken fettuccine. We're about to get the chicken going, but the chicken is being soaked right now. Green beans, Rotel for the nachos. And then, yeah. I ain't gonna show y'all me cooking this because this is already a lot, y'all, but I just wanted to show y'all my little setup. These are quick meals. For my chicken fettuccine, I am gonna make my own sauce. I might show y'all that, but I'm not gonna show y'all like the full video of me making it. If y'all want me to do a full video of making these meals, y'all should know how to make nachos, but the sauce, I can show y'all how I make that. Just let me know in the comments. Okay, meat is done, noodles is done, the cheese is almost done. I added the Rotel, and I took the chicken off because I'm about to make the Alfredo sauce. So basically, it is so easy. You're gonna use the same pan because all of this has seasoning. You're gonna put some whipping cream, heavy whipping cream, as much as or as little as you want, and put it on low. It's on low right now, but because I just took the chicken off, got to do it while it's still hot. Some whipping cream, and then you're gonna get some Parmesan and mozzarella. Okay, so I have this shredded cheese. This shredded Parmesan and this shredded mozzarella, and I'm gonna just pour all of this in there because This is a Cajun chicken fettuccine, and we want it extra cheesy. So I'm about to pour it. Hold on, y'all. Let me get my tripod. All right.
I'm gonna turn this fan off so y'all can hear me. Baby, it is. Sometimes my automatic fan comes on and it will not turn off until it cools down in here. So I did it before it did it, and it's annoying. So yeah, you see how much cheese I just added? I'm gonna have to add some more whipping cream though, because we like ours cheesy. But yep, all it's gonna do now is just simmer. Let me stir my cheese back here. This is the Velveeta cheese with the Rotel for the nachos. That's on a slow and low cook right now. See that? But you can't, but yeah. Let me move this closer. Yeah. Okay, so got all those Rotel in there. My meat is done, my noodles is done. I'm gonna sit that right there because that is done. I'm gonna get another wooden spoon for my cheese sauce, well, my Alfredo sauce. The goal is to make this as cheesy, as thick, or as loose as you want. It's really easy to make. If I have time, I usually like to make my own sauce, but if I'm just trying to make a quick meal for Nyla, I'll get the sauce in the can. I'm never too bougie for the sauce out of the can, but this is pretty much gonna get the seasoning from the chicken. But I always like to add a little bit more. Let me see if I have some more seasoning salt here. No, it is empty. Oh, I got a little bit. I'm gonna add a little bit of this. I need to refill this because it is empty. And I'm gonna add some Cajun seasoning. I don't wanna add too much seasoning because it's already seasoned. Get some slap your mama. Because this is a Cajun Alfredo. Nyla's gonna eat nachos tonight. I'm thinking I'm gonna have me some, I think I'm gonna have me some Alfredo, because this, ooh, look at that, y'all. So it's really clumpy right now, so you gotta let the cheese melt. And I have it on low because you don't wanna cook it. Like, you want it to just be simmered and just slow. Now, I don't like it, I like it thick. This is a little too thick. So I'm gonna pour a little bit more. Okay. Yeah, this is it. All right, so right now it's still, I'm gonna turn it up just a little bit. But yeah, so right now it is super thick still, but it's, oh, just how I like it. I'm gonna let it simmer a little bit more, cook a little more. But I do want it to loosen up just a little bit more. And it's all in the middle. So let me just like blend it. Let's check on the cheese. The cheese is starting to finally, it was taking too long, so I had to turn it up. And you know, it's starting to get there too. I don't want it to get stuck. This gas stove, y'all, ain't nothing to play with. So I gotta be on game. Oh, let me taste the sauce. Let me taste it. Oh my God. It's so good, but I'm gonna put a little bit more, I want a little bit more spicy. A little bit more spicy, and I want a little bit more salt. Let me give me some more salt. This has a little blend of everything, so I just grabbed this. And just get it a little bit. I put too much, oh my gosh. That's okay, it's a lot of sauce. Yeah, this is gonna be, look at it, that's what I'm talking about right there. Still got some clumps in it, but girl stop playing with me. Girl. Oh my Jesus, Lord Jesus. I should have had this on my cutting board, but baby, I'm hungry. And I just tasted this chicken. I just really be outdoing myself, y'all. Like, I don't even understand. And I know it's probably easier to cut the chicken before you cook it, but I always just cut it after I cook it. I don't know why I do that, but I just do. I think it's just easier for me. But yeah, the chicken's so good. And yeah, you just cut the chicken up, whether it's before or after, and it's so juicy. Okay, it didn't cut me. I just grazed my skin. It's so juicy. I don't want to dry the chicken out. Let me put this over here. And y'all probably like 6 pieces of chicken. That ain't a lot of chicken. But when you cut it up with all these noodles and this sauce, it is a lot of chicken. It is definitely a lot of chicken. Okay. I'm trying to hurry up, baby, because I'm hungry. I only had a salad today and some coffee. But yeah, y'all. This is my meal. It's Wednesday, so we can eat on both of these for few days. This is what I like about being home. I can make multiple meals and just be productive. You know what I mean? Yes, honey. Cut these chickens with a baby. All right. Chicken going over here. This is my kitchen right now. It is in shambles, but that is okay. All right. I don't want to overcook this, but let me taste it one more time before I pour it over the sauce. I'm gonna move y'all up. Okay, it's good. Got some clumps in it, like right here in the middle. That's because it's starting to cook it. You don't want that. You want it to still stay loose. So I'm gonna pour this over it. I'm gonna pour a little bit more whipping cream. I think I put a lot of cheese. I'm just a cheesy person. Let me get my mittens. I need to check on this Velveeta. That is the thing about quick and easy meals. Like John and I say, if you do a 2-in-1, both of them require attention. So you gotta make sure you on your best. Look at that. Lord T. Like, seriously. I ain't even got no flex. Hold on. That's my stove light. Hold on. Like, really? Really? Oh, God. Somebody. If you can top it, let me know. Okay? And by the way, I got this recipe from Jai. Jai's cooking book. Once I started making it the way she does, I ain't never made it no different. So the cheese is good. I'm gonna just pour this cheese right in this pan. I don't feel like getting another pot to pour it into and make it more dishes. Yeah, Nala wants nachos. I want the Alfredo. So let's get into it. And I'm gonna put some parsley over that Alfredo. Let me lift this up so y'all can see what I'm doing. I don't have my light. I should be working with my light. Honestly, I'm just about to get the big pot. It's gonna be a mess, but this will be better to do it with this. I'm just gonna have all these dishes in the sink full of dishes. I try to wash as I go, but with 2 quick meals, you gotta be right by the stove. I know this pot is so big for this, but I'd rather have this for that than that, let me get my mitten. Than that, pan. Let me get my other one. Okay, so that is over there simmering and smothering together. I'm gonna just pour all this in here. Okay. Yes. Y'all see that? Nachos. Alfredo. And I'm actually turning this Alfredo off. It's done. Yeah, that's our dinner. That is it. Yum, yum, yum. Okay, this is Cajun chicken Alfredo.
nachos.
Hey, let's do a taste test. Oh my God. Just leaving a coffee shop, Chamaria Yemeni. I might be saying that incorrectly, but I met there with this content creator that lives in Houston. Her name is Kai Lachey. Super sweet girl. I've been following her for like over a year. I mean, she has a content creator university where she gives like content creation tips and advice and things like that. So I'm a part of that, and she's invited a few of us to a coffee shop here in Houston, and I joined when I was off today, so it was perfect. But y'all was so, why are you looking at me? It was some good vibes, y'all, like good vibes. She is such a sweetheart. She's down to earth. She's just a type of woman that I want to be around. Like, that's the type of women that I want to be around, women that not only inspire you, but she's so young and she's just so, just a good soul. Like, you can tell she's just a good person. So I was just telling her the things that I do and what I have planned and what she has planned, and it was just good vibes. Like, that's the type of people I want to be around. Good energy people that light the fire under you to keep going and doing what you want to do. So, and she's just, she's like a little sister. That's my little sis now, okay? Anyway, so we went to the coffee shop. We were there for a little bit, and then we were like, oh, we hungry. So she suggested this place called, I think it's called Midwest Connection. Y'all, look at this. Well, you're gonna see the video, so I'm not even gonna worry. But this, oh, and I tasted it already. So good. Mm-mm. Me and her, we can't be together because we foodies. But, babe, my stomach gonna be hurting, but it's worth it. But I'm like an hour away from my house. Sorry, y'all. I'm like an hour plus away from my house. So I might as well just sit here and eat. But yeah, y'all. I had to pop in and tell y'all how it went. So good. I bet you this man think I'm talking to myself next to me. Now, today was so fun. Like, I really feel like what I want to do and the direction that I'm heading, God is purposefully aligning me with the people that I'm supposed to be aligned with. He's literally removing and replacing. So, amen to that. But anyway, y'all, I'm trying to just eat these chili. I should never got these chili cheese fries because I'm not gonna be able to eat this in drive. I'm gonna take my field trip back to my side of town. I'll chat with y'all later.